Meet Mario and Maestro. If you didn't know their genetic backgrounds or how they were raised, it would be difficult to decide if Mario or Maestro was the right bull for you. They both look physically similar, but how do you know what genetics each bull will pass on to their progeny? What if one was younger and the other born to a mature cow? Or one had been affected by disease and the other had access to better feed before the sale? You can't determine which bull will produce the better progeny just by looking at them. It's not that simple. How do we account for the factors which may affect how the bull presents on sale day, and most importantly, how its progeny will perform and ultimately affect your profitability? We do this with estimated breeding values, or EBVs. They're the best prediction of an animal's genetic merit for a particular trait and an indication of how an animal's progeny will perform. EBVs allow you to compare the real difference between the genetics Mario and Maestro will pass on to their progeny. Currently, you can only compare EBVs within a breed. There are EBVs for many different traits that impacts the performance and profitability of your herd, including fertility traits, calving ease traits, weight traits, carcass traits, and other traits such as temperament. All EBVs are reported in the units they're measured in, for example, kilograms for weight and millimeters for rump fat. EBVs are generated from the data your participating stud breeder collects from the animal in question, as well as from its parents and other relatives to provide this estimate of genetic merit. Let's take the EBV for 400 day weight. Mario is actually physically heavier than Maestro, but their genes tell a different story. With Maestro's EBV at plus 44 kilograms compared to Mario's at plus 32 kilograms, the physically younger and lighter Maestro is actually 12 kilograms genetically superior to Mario for this trait. Since Maestro's progeny will receive only half their genetics from Dad, his progeny will on average be 6 kilograms heavier than Mario's at 400 days of age. Now let's look at the EBV for rump fat. When we compare the two bulls genetically, Maestro has an EBV of plus 0.5 millimeters, while Mario's EBV is plus 2.5 millimeters. Mario has a 2 millimeter higher EBV for rump fat than Maestro, and since only half this genetic average will be passed on, Mario's progeny on average will have 1 millimeter more rump fat than Maestro's. As you can see, simply selecting bulls on their visual appearance alone has limitations in identifying the bull that will have the biggest impact on your productivity. Which is why EBVs, which are a measure of the genetic merits that will be passed on to the progeny, are an essential tool to be used alongside structural and temperamental assessments, as well as a bull check pass. When applied to bull selection decisions, EBVs can significantly improve your herd's performance and profits for many generations to come.